Next, an update on the Pakistan floods. Special Envoy Richard Holbrooke visited a relief camp in southern Pakistan today, highlighting U.S. relief contributions. His tour came as militant groups are also stepping into the aid effort. We get more on that now from the Punjab in central Pakistan. The reporter is Suzanna Koster of the international website GlobalPost.
Humanitarian efforts are in full swing on the outskirts of the town of Leya, 250 miles southwest of the capital Islamabad. It was hit hard by the massive flooding, and dozens of relief workers have come to provide food and medicine. But most aren't from an international aid group or the Pakistani government. They are from a hardline Islamic charity called Falah Insaniyat Foundation. Ataur Rahman is a senior representative of the group.
I came 2 days later, but our local people started working from the first day. The first day, we didn't have this tent. We were assessing.
On the other side of the road, the medical team gets ready.
This spot is ours. We sit here, some of us have breakfast here, and we plan and hold meetings here.
Falah has strong links to the terrorist group Lashkar-e-Taiba, which is blamed for the 2008 terrorist attacks in Mumbai that killed over 160 people. Lashkar's charity division was called Jamaat-ul-Dawa. It was shut down by the Pakistani government, but still appears to be alive and well and operating under the banner of Rahman's organization.
Jamaat ud-Dawa was our main donor of our work during this disaster. It was Jamaat ud-Dawa that gave us most of the needed material. They gave truckloads full of rice and sugar. We got a lot of support from other people, but most of it came from Jamaat ud-Dawa.
Rahman and his colleagues are here doing more than providing relief. They're also preaching.
Do you know with what hand you should eat? Put up your hand. It's your right hand. And what do you say before you start? In the name of God.
Falah is capitalizing on the fact that it can provide flood relief that the Pakistani government can't. In just this area alone, more than 300,000 people were affected by the flooding in August. Many lacking drinking water, food and shelter. The devastation can be seen everywhere. This used to be a road through sugarcane fields.
You can say it was not a river.
The water did not let us take our things. The houses started crumbling down. We quickly took our kids and a couple of animals, although we lost most of them. We saved our lives and came here.
Through their robust relief efforts, Falah has been able to buy loyalty.
These people reached at my village. And I see that these are the people there working actually, really. I astonished by the work of these people, the Falah Insaniyat Foundation. For this reason, I joined these people.
Talat Masood, a retired Pakistani army general, says that groups like Falah and its predecessor Jamaat ud-Dawa use disaster relief as a recruiting method.
They have a grassroots network which operates in several parts of the country. And so they're always actually, you find them, the first ones, because the government takes much longer to respond. And as it is, this government has never been very efficient. I would say that basically it's the Jamaat-e-Dawa and one or two other, which always have been, trying to assist or in the forefront whenever anything like this happens.
And so Rahman and his men preach on.
All misery a man meets in his life is because of his own deeds. He is responsible. God says, if you receive something good, it is mine. If you lose out, it is your own fault. Because we believe in this, we advise everyone to become good followers of God.
It is a message that's turning locals into believers.
We know the work of this organization, Lashkar-e-Taiba, for a long time. They take the pain and suffering of others as if it is their own.
Meanwhile, some 3 million flood victims have yet to receive aid, and international donor funds have nearly come to a standstill, according to the United Nations. To address the crisis, Pakistan's Prime Minister announced he will hold an international donor conference shortly. It's something that might help the government itself fill the aid gap instead of terrorist-linked charity groups.